Hey guys, this is Kyle. Just going to answer some questions about the ultimate dual striker build that I created. A lot of people will send me PMs in game and over the site asking me questions, why am I dying so much? And then they'll send me their passive tree or show me their gear, and I'll be like, oh, that's why. Very quickly, going to touch on some of the things I wrote on in the forum page, which you can see on the official Marauder builds list under Dual Striker. This guy does not use armor. He just doesn't need any. He's got some armor, iron reflexes, bare bones. This guy is all damage sponge and leech. So a lot of people will get this wrong. They'll go over here and grab some armor nodes. No, don't do that. It literally does nothing. They'll sacrifice life and they'll go for damage. They'll hit 100,000 DPS. I'm at 55,000 and they'll die all the time. Their clear speed will be maniacal. They'll reach a boss and get slaughtered. I can't emphasize this enough. My friend has substandard gear. He followed my build. He's got a 2x axe. He's got the second version of the Soul Taker, the second version of the Bringer of Rain. Similar gloves. He gets his max res from his belt. He's got calms. New versions of the roomies. And he clears maps on level 75 and above all day long. Not 80, but you know, level 75 seems to be a pretty good mark. He's level 82, and he does just fine. So far, he does great. And he's only doing 25,000 damage per second. And when he and I will jump in a map at the same time, and every time he jumps, everything's dead. Then I'll jump, everything's dead. And there's no difference. So hitting 100,000 damage per second, even 50,000 is not necessary. The only thing that makes my axes really good for this build is that bigger hits very fast means more leech. So here's the strategy you guys need to shoot for if you do want to do this build. One is leech is your main defense. Secondly, life pools, that's your second defense. And third, you have block. And then fourth, you have attack speed. And yes, attack speed is defense with this build. If you've ever played Diablo 2, a smiter paladin with Dracul's gloves, those gauntlets, then you'll understand where I got this build. I'm a big D2 fan. At least I was before they hacked it to death. So this guy literally mimics that. When I saw 3 years ago in Domination League the Soul Taker Axe and the Bringer Rain combo pop up and become popular as a fun glass cannon build, I'm like, oh my god, I have to do that. And it's been a long haul. This is not a casual character. He is definitely elite, he is expensive, and he is hard to put together. He is crushingly difficult to put together. He is so gear dependent, it's absolutely disgusting. But when he finally comes together and you get that godly speed and you just don't ever die anymore and you just crap all over Atsiri, it's just glee. And one of the only characters where you can actually complete this guy and you're not bored still. You can actually run around and just kill stuff and it's actually fun. These games tend to die when you finish your character. You're just like, okay, no more goals, let's do another character. He's been my sole character for the last 2 years. So leech is his main defense. So basically, here's how you're gonna think of this. One, more leech percent means you can do more leech per hit. And this is important because you do a lot of really small hits. And that's where having a really expensive axe pays off, because it maximizes your leech per hit. So the average player with a older Bringer of Rain and a fast siege axe, you know, the 1.8 and above attack speed built in onto the axe itself, you know, they'll be leeching very fast, and they'll do great damage. They can do, you know, 9 attacks a second. I'm at 11.12. And basically, what happens is he does all these tiny hits, and it just doesn't take long for the leech to take effect. So there's a queue, and a lot of people don't understand this. They'll do some leech, and it'll take a second to, so they'll get 200 life and a hit, and it'll take 3 seconds to get that 200 life. This doesn't really happen with this guy, because his little hits are so far beneath the leech cap. So mine right now is 1411. I did the calculations. So doing 11.1 attacks per second, and I'm doing about 1500 to 2600 on my main hand axe per hit, and that's multiplied by like 11, obviously. You really, you know, I'm not hitting the leech cap still, and I average 1100 to 1800 in a second. So he'll hit that leech cap in one-on-one boss fights almost exclusively, because they're doing the big damage. They're doing, you know, they'll drop him down to 500 health, and then, you know, boom, he starts chewing away at the boss to get his life back. And then it'll just take 3 seconds or so, because it'll cap. And that's where having a lot of life helps, because more life means faster leech rate, because you're going to fill in these nodes, so faster leech rate, 20%, 5% of max life per second, so more life just generally increases the cap, and then you've got these other bonuses which increase it further. You really maximize his ability to damage sponge. So most other characters, they're tanky because they avoid damage, or they negate it, like with Purity of Fire against Atsiri. I don't do that. I specifically made this guy to be completely free of anything that could change. So when I did my Atsiri fight, I constantly get dropped to like 1,000 life, and some people look at that and they say, oh, he could die. You could probably find a tankier build. Well, obviously, if I equip Purity of Fire and a Fire Potion, I would have 2,500 life out of the 60, you know, the 6,000 I had at the time in the video, and then it wouldn't be an issue anymore, and he'd look tankier. But the point is, he doesn't need it. He doesn't die against Atsiri. He just doesn't die, and that's because he can take the damage with the high life, and he'll leech it all back immediately. If he's, you know, in the weeds, you could say, you've got a block pot. He's got 74% 60 block, so he can block those spells and block all those attacks, and that further prevents the leech queue from being a downfall. The other thing is that attacking is defensive. So this is where this build really shines. He doesn't do as well skirting enemies. That's why I wrote down in the explanations on how to level with him, don't be cautious. This guy was made to jump into mobs, plain and simple. Because in mobs, he just attacks everything simultaneously. So 11 enemies a second for me. And basically, they get stunned when you jump. It activates Fortify, which gives them 20% flat from hits damage reduction. And then it gives them an Endurance Charge, which discharges if he does get attacked, which gives him up to a second of physical damage immunity. And then he's got his block. So if all of those fail, he's leeching and still losing life, and he has the physical damage immunity, he's still getting pecked to death, and he's getting shot with spells to death, and all that is still happening, you still have block to just flat out negate the damage anyway. You don't need crap tons of damage. So many people keep hitting 100,000 DPS. Sure, that's fun. And then they go against the boss and they die in one hit. It's because it's not how you do this build.